This project is a collaboration between different researchers from different European institutions, and is presented as an evolution of traditional splints. Industrial design and advanced manufacturing have made it possible an enormous growing of new industry. The optimization of the process, new materials, and the decrease of the cost have produced an expansion of these techniques further than the industrial area to applications known as bioengineering. Clear examples of these advances are surgery prosthesis, therapy for acne, orthopedic surgery or rehabilitation, and moreover, it simultaneously improves wearing comfort and hygiene. This study focuses on the implementation of all these concepts, showing the development and prototyping of a smart immobilization splint using a 3D scanner and biocompatible material. This new concept of splint allows different treatments, and it also includes sensors to get pressure, temperature, color scheme, and humidity of the immobilized area. When injury occurs, it may appear normal inflammatory signs like variation of the temperature, change in skin color, sweating, or edema. For this reason, the parameters considered for this study are pressure, temperature, humidity, and skin color, and in total, four different sensors are used. These data are combined to determine if there are any signs of an expected evolution during the training. A microcontroller mounted on an OLED display and battery board, that also includes Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, makes it possible to consult this data in a remotely way. The first part of the process is the 3D scanning of the injured part by using a 3D scanner. In this case, it is used a 3D system sense scanner that offers enough technical specifications to get a good quality model. When the scanning process is finished, a 3D points cloud is obtained that must be cleaned and post-processed to get a 3D model. After that, it is included an offset of 0.5 mm so that the model fits with comfort. Also, it is generated a thickness for the part. After this process, it is possible to handle the file with a parametric design program. By using a 3D design parametric program, different windows for the treatments are created. In this case, the considered treatments are electrostimulation, interferences, laser, sonotherapy, and drains. Also in this point, different housings of the sensors are created. In this case, the considered sensors are two temperature sensors, one temperature and humidity sensor, two pressure sensors, and one color sensor. When the design process is completed, the part is cut into two different parts to make it possible to fix it over the limb, and it is sent to a 3D printer. In order to get the data from the sensors by using the microcontroller, it is necessary to develop a small electronic PCB to connect everything needed. This board includes the connection for the controller, some electronic components, and the connection for the sensors. It is powered by a battery of 5 volts. This electronic board is assembled with the sensors and the microcontroller in the manufactured splint. The acquired data can be consulted by scrolling all the display that it is included on the electronic board. This way, the system is completely autonomous. Also, this data can be consulted remotely by using our server that it is included on the microcontroller. For example, a doctor is able to follow the treatment from any place in the world. In order to test the prototype, it is placed on the leg of the volunteer during 1.5 hours, with a sampling period of 3 seconds. Two sensors in contact with the skin get the temperature of the area. The obtained temperature is slightly lower than the human body temperature. This fact is completely normal, due to there is only one phase of the sensor in real contact with the skin, and the sensor detects also the surface not in contact, which is at a lower temperature. However, this info is enough to detect any change of the temperature of the zone. A third sensor gets the humidity and temperature of the internal part of the splint. The knowledge of this parameter allows to anticipate to the appearance of bacteria due to humidity, which is especially critical in case of surgery injuries. Also, an increment of sweating is a symptom of problems that may happen after an injury. Two more sensors get the pressure between the skin and the spleen in two different axes. If the pressure of the area is increased due to inflammatory signs, this sensor will perfectly detect the increment of the pressure inside the splint. The color sensor uses the RGB color model. This one is an additive color model in which red, green, and blue light are added together in various ways to reproduce a broad array of colors. The data may oscillate between the values 0 and 255. The first figure shows the data acquired when the sensor is placed over a region of the skin with no hematomas, whereas the second one shows the data when the sensor is placed over a hematoma. With this method, it is possible to detect when a hematoma shows up in the region of the skin. The increment is about a 33% of the red value, a 23% of the green value, and a 28% of the blue value. It is possible to find a relation between temperature patterns and medical conditions. This is due to metabolism and local blood flow that generates located temperature variations. It will also be possible to create a digital mapping of the temperatures under the splint by adding more sensors. The humidity and pressure values are also correctly acquired. As with the temperature, it is possible to detect variations due to internal sweating and pressure produced by an inflammatory process. The possibility of getting a continuous monitoring of these parameters allows to know the progression at any time of the treatment. Finally, by using the RGB sensor, it is possible to detect variations in the three components of the light. When a hematoma shows up, the concentration of blood on a determined area produces a change of the color of the skin. The sensor is able to detect a variation of the three components of the light, so it avoids the necessity of removing the splint to check the skin. With this innovative project, it is intended to provide an evolution for the traditional splints that have remained practically intact since their invention in the 10th century. As it is showed in this study, this autonomous system powered by a battery is able to get information from the sensors. The different parameters considered at the beginning of the study may be consulted locally and remotely. It is proposed as an evolution of the study, the incorporation of an algorithm that may notify of an unexpected evolution by using the different collected data.